Alright, let's get started. Alright, so if you're wondering what this game is, it is an old legend. SpongeBob Battle for Bikini Bottom. It's great. What is wrong with my links page thing? That's annoying.
Today is the big day. I have devised an ingenious plan to finally steal the Krabby Patty formula. And if Bikini Bottom happens to get demolished in the process, oh well. With my brand new Duplicatotron 3000, I'll clone an army of robots that will wreak mayhem and destruction at my command! One last review of the checklist. Let's see. Item number one, is Plankton a genius? Answer yes! Okay, checklist complete. Throw in the switch! Welcome, my perfectly obedient robot army. Hang on, I want to get a photo for my scrapbook. Hey, hello? What do you think you're doing? Oh, no, 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 wait, but I'm your master. I made you. No, no, oh, my good China.
That was a stupid
Another
plan.
Perfect day playing robots and racehorses.
Yeah, only I keep getting the racehorses and the robots mixed up.
Wouldn't it be great if we had real robots to play with, Patrick? I'd name mine Robo Junior, or Zorlon, or maybe Frankie.
Yeah, these unreal robots are getting boring. Hey, what if we put the robots in here?
Oh, how shellfish of you.
Not just any shell, it's my magic wishing shell.
Wow, that's great, Patrick.
So we put the toy robots in here.
Okay.
Then we say the magic wishing words and shake the magic wishing shell.
Okay.
Then we go to sleep, and in the morning, we'll have real robots to play with.
But Patrick, aren't we going to say the magic wishing words?
You already did!
So, okay is the magic wishing word?
It used to be Alakazama Alabala Wisna Tikitana Fushbar Griddle Bits von Vita Schnauzer, but I kept forgetting it.
Are you sure this'll work?
Sure! Last week I only had one big cookie crumb and I was really hungry, so I put my cookie crumb in the magic wishing shell. Then I said the magic wishing word and shook it, and in the morning I had lots of little cookie crumbs!
Patrick, I proclaim that tomorrow is going to be the best day ever!
Good night, SpongeBob!
Good night, Patrick!
The next morning...
Gonna play with robots, gonna play with robots, gonna play with robots, gonna play with... Wow! Gary, did you do that?
Yeah, Gary. It sure looks like we're in a doozy of a pickle. I think I'm gonna have to learn a lot in order to fix this mess.
Wow!
What a fantastic idea! These signs will provide important tips to help me out! How do I read the signs?
Wow!
Oh, okay! Press this button to read the signs. So if I want to come back and talk to you again, just walk up to you and press this button. I'd better get started now, Gary. I think that this is going to be a very long day.
Okay, neato. So this game is, very old.
Bikini Bottom residents.
Like, I think this is a 2003. So we're gonna have some old school classic fun.
So much for fixing this quietly.
Authorities are not sure who is responsible for unleashing the mechanical menaces, but they have assured us that the person is in big, big trouble.
Uh-oh.
Did I say big trouble? I meant so enormous that it's hard to comprehend trouble. We'll keep you posted as this tragic story unfolds. Tragically, we're sure.
Alright, so I'm going to be collecting a lot of these things. They're called shiny objects. They're basically the currency.
As a faithful crew member of the Krusty Krab,
yeah, it's kind of like Jack and Daxter. You get the power cells. In this game, you get golden spatulas.
Wow! A promotion!
That's right! A promotion! So what this here new job entails is you collecting all these shiny objects that the robots are leaving behind and bringing them to me. Now stop seahorsing around and get busy collecting.
It shines! I make myself a snack, but there's no time!
Get everything in here, yeah. So you're going to see a lot of that. I'm missing some shiny objects. Ah, there it is. Show you how you get hurt in this game. Oh shit. What's up, Diana? Ahoy to you too. Just kind of running through the tutorial stuff right now. Spongebob uses all these like bubble attacks and whatnot, and it's neato. You get to play as Patrick and Sandy too later on in the game. But for now, I think we're just gonna do SpongeBob. I might even go through this entire game. Who knows? Speaking of which, this game is easy. Yeah, yeah. No one said I was gonna be playing a hard game today. In fact, might not even end up playing a game that I wanted to play this week, which was Wind Waker HD. For like 3 days, I wanted to essentially, where am I going with playing? I wanted to play Wind Waker HD with my buddies, but they have to drive quite a ways to get to where I am. And in the state that I live in, Minnesota, we having some issues. And that issue is, it's gonna snow again, even though it is in the middle of the spring, essentially. So that's neat. Right now, I'm playing this game because of nostalgia. I've never actually played Banjo. I should probably, like, go find me a copy of Banjo-Kazooie. Heard nothing but good things about it. I know it's supposed to be, like, really good.
You're polluting my thinking space.
Try
trying to steal the Krabby Patty formula again, eh, Plankton? Well, you won't get away with it.
I've got bigger fish to fry. I've got to figure out how to regain control of the chum bucket from those robots.
Where did they come from?
Where? I don't know. Not for me, though, that's for sure. They just showed up out of nowhere and started calling.
You don't like the last two levels of this game or of Banjo-Kazooie?
They even bent all my spoons. I love those spoons like they were my children.
That's terrible.
Oh, won't you help me stop them before they bent all my forks?
Ah, I see.
Not the forks!
Golden spatulas, eh? SpongeBob, if you can get me back into the chum bucket, I'll give you a bucket full of golden spatulas. In your dreams.
You've got a deal.
Alright, you know. So we're supposed to go to Jellyfish Fields, but first I want to go do some stuff. Fuck around out here. Most of my favorite games aren't even that hard, unfortunately. I think the hardest thing I've ever had to do was... Oh, forgot that is timed. Wow. The hardest thing I've ever had to do, I think, like, as in the games that I like, is Bloodborne. I'm not really a big fan of the Soulsborne series, but I really liked that, and I was like, yeah, I think I'll start playing more of those. Eventually. Gosh, I do not remember this game. Ooh. If you're a fan of Zelda, then hopefully me and my buddies can manage to play Wind Waker.
What song?
The one you're standing on.
Oh, that one. It's lost.
This is for GameCube, but it's also on original Xbox as well.
Oh, they're more lost. A bunch of robots came through here and stole my whole sock collection. I could use some help getting them back.
Sure, that would have been a PS2 game, too. And I think there was a crappy Game Boy Advance game of the version of this.
For every 10 socks you bring back to me, I'll give you a golden turkey baster.
You mean spatula?
Bless you.
Neat. You never need to do laundry.
I know not a whole lot is going on right now, because I'm just literally just picking up all the shiny objects, but I don't know. Collect-a-thons. This is why I don't play collect-a-thons a whole bunch. I'm kind of OCD about it. And I'm like, yep, gotta get everything. You can see me playing Sunshine.
Hey, Sponge!
Bubble Buddy!
You see, you're going to need to learn some new bubble-blowing moves if you're going to journey to the ninth dimension and defeat the giant monkey man!
I need to do is figure out how to get rid of these robots.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Wind Waker is freaking great. You should totally tune in if we decide to do it. It's gonna be probably Friday. Super Mario Sunshine is the worst game ever. Hold your tongue. Don't even get me started.
With bubble power that defeats anything that is directly above you. Try it out.
In what capacity is it the worst game ever? Are you trolling? I feel like you're trolling. Yeah, let's talk to Mr. Crab. Blah blah blah, he wants me to give him a bunch of shiny objects. Alright, we're gonna go bother Squidward now.
First, those
stupid robots ruined a perfectly relaxing mud bath this morning.
Well, to each their own, I guess. I mean, what's your favorite Mario game?
I am so sorry, Squidward. Patrick and I were just playing a game and...
Oh, I correct myself. I should have known that whole robot problem involved both of you.
Squidward, I don't know what...
Don't tell me you're one of those Mario 64 purists. Because Mario 64, that's great. I've beaten the crap out of that game plenty of times. Beaten the crap out of Sunshine plenty of times. Galaxy 1 and 2. Loves me some Odyssey. I don't know. I just like Mario. But Sunshine had... It did have some problems, I will say that. But... Those problems kind of made it into a different game. It's kind of like how the glitches in Melee made it a better game. Same kind of deal. Paper Mario was great. I've only really played the 64 one. I like the Mario and Luigi series, at least the first two entries. Everything else is too easy. But I don't really do a whole bunch of turn-based combat. Alright, I'm not getting all these tiki's again. Ooh, but I do need to go into Patrick's house. Hello, Diamond. Yes, I know it's 2019. I like nostalgia. I only ever really announce ahead of time the, like, big games I'm gonna play. Those big games would be, like, newer games, like, current year games, or games that happened in the last couple of years, like... For example, Wind Waker HD, that's gonna be a thing, hopefully, weather permitting.
The rolling green hills of jellyfish fields, a place to experience nature.
I don't know what to tell you guys, I just had a hankering for this game. Not a whole lot of people are playing old games like this. Everyone's playing like Apex Legends and whatnot. I don't know. Got a little bored. Yes, Wind Waker HD is indeed on Wii U.
By applying a thick layer of king jellyfish jelly to the affected areas. King jellyfish?
Well, I guess you're off the scale Sport Mountain and die a horrible death under the vicious tentacles of king jellyfish. I'll stay here, balled up here in excruciating pain.
You do that! Don't worry, Squidward. I'll bring back that king jellyfish jelly for you to rub all over yourself.
Neato. We have our first mission. Hooray! Diamond, how do you feel about Super Mario Sunshine? Gotta know.
Jellyfish today. I'm going fishing for a
Yeah, I have to agree. Speedruns for Sunshine are pretty fun to watch. They're pretty fun to do, too. With glitches, without glitches, it's just great. So, Big Buds, try not to hate. I'm not even mad. I dislike trolling, but yeah, no. Don't ever insult that game ever again. No, I haven't played Odyssey in a long time. I should probably get used to doing speedruns of that. But my friend currently has it. I borrowed it to him. Haven't seen him in a while. Odyssey is one of those like masterful speedruns that like you see people do, and they do it so perfectly. You're just like, how did you even do that? You learn new things every time you watch any kind of run of it, even if it's not a speedrun. Any percents are pretty fun. But, I don't think I myself at this level that I'm at could pull it off. Odyssey is a choke. I can beat it in 2 hours, but the record is 1 hour or less than an hour, so. Okay, bye. Have fun beating games super fast and, you know, talking trash. I'll miss you. Come back. Like, favorite, subscribe. Just kidding. Do what you want. I'm not your mom. Oh, you're not going? I'd like if you stayed. But you don't have to. Big Buzz, don't even worry about it. I'm fucking with you right now. Alright, have a good day or night, whatever time it is, wherever you're at. Thanks for tuning in. This game is fucking weird. I'm being pretty OCD about getting all these shiny things, because I don't honestly know how much I'll need for this run. It's not even like a speed run, it's just I'm gonna do the least amount, essentially, to get through the game. This is like a placeholder for if we don't do Wind Waker, or if I don't end up buying another game like, DMC5 sounds good, to be honest. But I know has. Okay, that hit me, cool. Hit detection in this game is great. That was nice of them to bounce me all the way back. Do I still feel like a lot of them? Yeah, probably. About left to subscribe. What a guy. What a handsome king.
Wow, Mermaid Man. I have all your comics and toys and mail.
What? Oh, yeah, it's that sponge kid. And now, what was I supposed to tell you?
That Patrick is surrounded by robots and needs my help.
How would he know that?
No, I think it had something to do with massaging my feet.
Well, if massaging your feet will save Patrick, then massage I must.
Help! They're making me hit myself!
Massaging your feet isn't working. I think I'd better try a more direct approach.
By clipping my toenails?
Here I come, Patrick!
This game is dumb. There's a PC click, point and click adventure with this? What? I did not know that. I just play the crap out of this game.
Okay.
hard to tell, like, the blast radius of this. Alright, now I get to play as Patrick. Cool. Neat.
Hey, SpongeBob!
Woo! Thank goodness you're safe, Patrick.
Well, of course, SpongeBob. Why wouldn't I be?
Well, the robot and the...
Oh, yeah, I found this for you. I don't know what it is, but it looks important.
Thanks, Patrick. I tell you what, all that running around has left me pooped. Why don't you continue on for a bit?
Okay. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy!
Cool.
Up we go!
Alright, so Patrick can pick up fruit and throw it at things. And that's neat. He can also pick up other things. Tiki's. This is like TNT from Crash Bandicoot. Do you remember what these are?
Yesterday, and now my neck hurts.
Heed my words, my large future minion. Go into Jellyfish Cave. Follow the instructions on the signs that you see. At the end of the caves, you'll still be a big pink idiot, but you'll know enough to help defeat the robots and get me back into the chum bucket.
Well, then will you vaporize me?
I might spare your life so I can force you to work in my sweatshop making low-quality design and knockoff wallets.
Oh, thank you!
Plankton owns a sweatshop, confirmed.
I wonder what this does.
Don't remember that in the TV show. I didn't even do anything to it. Why did it aggro on me? I need this question mark. Well, just to do this. It's kind of dumb. It did not unlock. Ah, well. Thank you. Did you want to auto lock on the one that I want? No? That'd be nice. There it is. Thanks, man. Purple thingy over there. I probably don't need that. Surface wave. There you go over there. Probably. What about? You guys hear that air horn? I think an accident just happened outside. I can't tell. Thank you.
Mrs. Pop.
Hello, Patrick. I've got a job for you to do.
Oh, boy.
I found a golden spatula, but those robots out on the island stole it and threw it into the lake. If you can figure out how to get it back, you're welcome to it.
Sure enough, Mrs. Pop.
All right, bet. I have no idea how that hit him. The hitboxes and hurtboxes in this game are very poorly defined. Switch back to SpongeBob.
Well done, Patrick. You're a real star.
Did I get a cookie?
No.
We gotta sneak up on these tees. I'd have to come back here when I have the cruise bubble, but I don't have the cruise bubble, so we're leaving. Oh, I totally missed that jump. Well. There, easy peasy, kill me pleasy.
Bubble Buddy! Gosh, everyone is trying to help out today!
Step quietly there. That king jellyfish is just up at the top of this path. Good.
Thanks, Bubble Buddy.
Okie dokie. Let's go kill us a jellyfish. A king jellyfish. Forget how to kill this guy. I'm sure it's gonna be obvious though. Yeah, like that.
Me.
That's the whole level, I think.
See, no problem. You can do anything you set your mind and your muscle to.
I didn't even have, like, the dialogue to establish that he wanted me to get that, but alright.
My best friend Squidward, can I rub some on?
What if I just gave you this?
Neato. Okay, so I guess I can just leave.
Downtown Bikini Bottom, once a bustling metropolis, now a debris-covered crater.
So this place, from what I remember, is a lot less, like, straightforward.
The robots are destroying downtown Bikini Bottom. We have to evacuate!
Alright, but it's gonna take a while to get all this dust.
Not vacuum. Evacuate! We have to get everyone to safety.
Can we just load them up in the boats?
That won't do any good.
Why not?
Because the robots have taken all the steering wheels.
Couldn't we just drive in a straight line?
No, there are too many turns.
Those fiends! They thought of everything! Never fear, Mrs. Puff. I'll get those steering wheels back.
SpongeBob, if you're involved, I always fear. But I tell you what, if you can pull this off, I'll give you a golden spatula.
How about a driver's license instead?
Nice try.
Number one of the bottom scavenger hunt.
Now that's just open. Just neat. LOL. Great joke. 10 out of 10.
Hunt 3 years running. Thank you.
this part. It's a random cannon. Shooting random shit. Kitchen appliances. Stop to that.
Just my side. I feel like a new star.
Locked from the inside. Who would do such a thing?
I mean, it's not my house, so. Heal, but there's some stuff I have to do first.
Hi, Gary.
Meow.
Yes, thanks for noticing. I have been working out.
Meow.
Not done. Doesn't that mean?
Meow.
Oh, thanks for the subscribe. Just noticed. Chromex Robin and Cornex Camilla, lover and supporter. That is a long name. Like, super duper.
Oh, that's the entrance.
I take it, though.
Top, which leads to the lighthouse? Uh-huh. There's another golden spatula. I could really use that.
Wow.
What do you mean, get Sandy to help me? I can get through this.
Meow, meow.
Oh, that gap looks big. Okay, I'm definitely not making that jump. How is anyone going to get across there? Uh-oh, more robots. Holy Dutchman's ghost! That gap looks impossible! And impassable! Okay, I'll go get Sandy to help me out.
I get to play as Sandy, who is objectively the best.
Someone better make good use of all of this. I'm getting dizzy just watching.
You can't tell by now that she's the best. She also knows karate, or karate. And she can lasso shit.
Gotcha.
there something on top of that thing? Like a sock or something? Definitely can't make that jump. Probably should have did that later, but whatever. We'll go around, it's fine. Don't even worry about it. Oh, I guess the box was down there. I didn't pay attention. Classic me.
Hey, Larry, what's shaking?
Sandy! Boy, am I glad to see you. I need your help. My TV reception has been terrible lately. I need to have someone replace my old antenna with this shiny new one.
Yes, sir. That there antenna is shinier than a $3 bill. Well, why don't you replace it yourself?
I'm not really much of a jumper.
So, what's jumping got to do with it?
Because the old antenna is up there.
Woo! That's taller than a glass of Texas iced tea.
The robots have blocked off that building, and I can't do all those fancy moves you and SpongeBob do to get across these gaps. All I can do is flex! Wanna see?
Yeah, great. So what are you gonna do with the old antenna?
Oh, that? It's yours if you replace it with a new one.
Well, I have been getting bad TV reception in the tree dome. Okay, Larry, you got a deal.
Cool. Thank you. Might as well get this one. I'll get to that one. Guess I can just jump.
There's another one.
Cool, cool, cool. Alright. Cool. So now I gotta SpongeBob. Let's activate this. I don't know if I have to be Sandy again, but. open the box and see if I need to talk to Larry the Lobster again.
What's happening, SpongeBob?
Hey, Larry.
That's annoying. Well, I guess if you switch, alright, it just goes back. Whatever. That's kinda lame. Kinda lame. Easy.
Number one in the Bikini Bottom scavenger hunt. 3 years running. Thank you. Boy, Patrick will be glad to have this back.
Alrighty.
You'll have to open this door from the inside.
Thanks, Bubble Buddy. I know. Alright. Space Needle? Space Needle.
Someone's broken the sea needle.
That's horrible. The sea needle is the cradle of Crochet Corner.
Yes, yes it is. But what's more important is that there are tikis and shiny objects just outside the windows.
Mr. Krabs, how can you think of money at a time like this?
Easy. I just clear my mind. Money, money, money. Now listen here, boy. You know that I'll give you golden spatulas if you bring me shiny objects. But I'm going to sweeten the deal. If you can break all the tikis here at the Sea Needle, I'll give you a bonus golden spatula.
Why would I want to break the tikis, Mr. Krabs?
Cause they were laughing at you and calling you funny names.
What kind of funny names?
You know, SpongeBob Butt Pants.
That's not very funny.
No, but they said your mom was ugly.
Ugly? All right, Mr. Krabs, break to my shell. You got a deal.
Let's see. Guess I'll stay SpongeBob so I can go do that mission. You can do a lot more near the end of the game in this place. You need, like, a super move you don't get for a while now. I did? Question mark? Did I miss one? Oh, I gotta go to each and every window. Got it.
Thank you.
Sick.
Good work, boy. Here's the golden spatula, like I promised.
So apparently I am missing one. There it is. Another mission somewhere out here. Can't remember where it's at.
SpongeBob, you don't have a driver's license.
Oh, don't I?
No, you don't.
Well, if I don't, then what's this?
A library card.
Oh.
This is where the mission is.
A simple button is most satisfying. Push, 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 push.
Cool. Where do I have to transform into Sandy? Question mark.
Thank you.
And just like that, ladies and gentlemen, that's how it's done. Can I leave as Sandy? Only special one can take the taxi. Cool. Next area.
Well, here's your old back scratch.
Spatula.
I don't speak Italian.
So, do you want to trade that's quality craftsmanship? Come again.
Yeah.
Sun-drenched beach of sludge at the bottom of the sea. But all is not well here on Paradise.
This level's neat. A little bit more linear than the last one we were at, but it's neat.
Do I look burned?
Well, you do look a little red.
Barnacles! That darn robot.
Robot?
Yeah, a big robot stole everybody's sunscreen.
Oh no! Everyone will burn, and then they'll get all itchy and peeled.
Exactly! You can't spend a day at the beach without sunscreen. That sun is way too hot. That robot is out on the island. Nobody can get to him. SpongeBob, maybe you can use those sun reflectors to point the sun's rays on that robot. If you hit one of the buttons on the side of a lifeguard tower, the reflector will turn. Connect all the towers, and the light will shoot right out of the big reflector on the island. Then all you have to do is swim out to the island and turn the big reflector onto the robot. I'll stay here and protect the babes.
But I, can't swim.
Thank you. this one. Seems accurate. All I have to do is just get over to that island later, and we will have done it.
Children's balloons have been overfilled. They're carrying the children out of control.
What kind of problem is this?
I don't know, Mrs. Pop. It looks like they're having a lot of fun.
Yes, too much fun, if you ask me. You can save the children by bubble bashing each of the balloons. Bubble bash all the balloons, then come see me for a reward.
Can do, Mrs. Pop. Like a spring
Do I need to switch characters? No, I don't think so. It's like just out of my reach. What the hell? There it is. That was annoying. Oh, honestly thought this kid was gonna fall into the goo and then just die, because he probably can't swim. Good on you, Nickelodeon, for not letting me do that. Well.
SpongeBob, I heard that you were collecting golden spatulas.
Yes, Bubble Buddy, I am. Have you seen one?
Why, yes. We were having a sandcastle contest, and somebody put a golden spatula on the top.
If I had a castle, I'd name it Fort Patty Town III, and Fort Patty Town III would have a big bake sale every Monday.
The golden spatula?
Oh, at the top of the sandcastle, right. That should be easy to reach.
Well, perhaps you should see for yourself.
Kerblooey! Sometimes pushing a simple button is the most satisfying. Push, 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 push. Water rising. Must get to higher. Boom!
Yes.
Gary. What's new?
Meow.
You don't say. Squidward bought a new sweater. Oh, he's so crazy.
Meow.
And there's a golden spatula at the end of this.
Sorry, lad, but the carnival is a pesky robot has taken over me ticket booth. And worse, me money. If you help me get rid of that no-good robot, I'll give you a big reward. Exactly what I had in mind. I hope my insurance covers all this.
Why don't you try something less expensive? Dangerous.
I need them crazy robots cleared out of the bumper boats. When you've destroyed them all, come back and see me.
Yeah.
where fish quite right. You gotta carry a lot of stuff around. Hey, what just happened?
Honestly, there's a whole lot more stuff to do here, but I don't care. What's good, Andrew? I am just playing Bikini Bottom. Battle for Bikini Bottom, as you can tell, obviously.
Congratulations, SpongeBob! You're king of the beach! Here, have a golden spatula!
That'll be enough, to be honest. Kind of want to move on to the next area. Call it good. Alright, let's progress the story, I guess.
I have brought you two here to face a great challenge.
I've got nerves of steel and muscles of sand.
And eyes of jelly.
My Poseidon has been breached by a mighty foe whom you must vanquish.
Bring it on, Your Highness! Bring it on!
In this corner,
defending the Poseidon, a small square guy. And his challenger, a huge murderous robot shaped like a squirrel.
Look, it's a giraffe.
I think I need to get home to feed Gary.
I don't remember how to do this.
Oh, that's gotta sting! Looks like the robot's left itself vulnerable! Great barrier reef!
Okay, I guess that's how you heard it. The first time. This game's too easy. That's what we previously established. You're not wrong. The puns have been really, really bad throughout this entire game. But of course, Dylan would be pissing his actual pants, literally, if he heard any of this crap. Clothesline spring. The old clothesline move. God.
Nice move by SpongeBob. This match is just about over.
And one more. Spring. No. No? Oh. Wow. Time for the coup de grace then.
Oh,
quite a battle. Tell him what he's won, Johnny.
It's a new power, the Bubble Bowl. But wait, there's more. A golden spatula, and that's not all. A gift certificate for $5.32 to Dean's little shop of dried fish flakes and flowers.
Oh, thank you. It all means so much. I promised myself I wouldn't cry.
Cry all you want, but not here. We just wax the floors.
LOL, great SpongeBob content. Am I right, fellas? Madams? Whomever might be watching?
Hey, Plankton.
Yes, what is it?
I was just wondering why all the robots seem to be coming from inside the chum bucket.
Have they? I really haven't noticed.
Yeah. And then there's that big flashing neon sign that says, Robot Headquarters.
SpongeBob, I'm your friend, right?
No, not really.
Exactly. And as your non-friend, I worry about you. Like right now, you're thinking too much. I'm worried you might really hurt yourself. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna think for you. This way you won't hurt yourself. And you can just keep working on getting me into the chum bucket.
Thanks, Plankton. You're the best non-friend a friend could have. No more thinking for me.
Let's see. Let's go to Sandy Street on, why not? And I died at the very end. That's amazing. Secret speedrunning trick? Die and therefore you don't have to walk all the way up to the person? Ha. Forgot, this is just a place where you can just look at character models for the enemies. And then just put that in the options menu? Whatever. So I can go to either rock bottom, or I can go to Shady Shoals and go talk to Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy.
They teach you how to bowl a bubble. Press this button, and you'll bowl a bubble that can knock down robots from a safe distance.
Wow!
Remember, though, the bubble bowl only works on things that are close to the ground.
Got it.
Yeah, we don't do that stuff anymore, kid. We're retired.
Is that the TV repairman?
No, it's that excited sponge kid again.
Oh, are you sure he can fix the TV?
Mermaid Man, 'twould be my greatest honor to fix your television.
Sponge Kid, you really want to help out?
No, boy, would I?
Okay, then. But lighten up a bit on the enthusiasm, huh? You're making my bowels act up. We've got a little problem with some robots down in the Mermalair. Are you sure you're up to this task?
Absolutely, Barnacle Boy.
Well, go over to the couch to access the Mermalair. We'll meet you down there.
Is it pudding night yet?
Checkers, the king of all contact sports.
This is a Bikini Bottom news update. We're getting unconfirmed reports that the robot menace is emanating from the chum bucket. The proprietor, Plankton, has released the following statement. Hear me now! I'll crush you all beneath my... And now back to your regular programming. Retirement home girls gone wild.
You know, for kids.
Boy.
You shouldn't sneak up on Mermaid Man like that. His heart's not so good. Come to think of it, nothing on him is that good anymore.
Sorry, Mermaid Man. It's just that I'm always so excited to see you two. Standing in your awesome presence gives me the chills of justice. See? I've got goosebumps on my goosebumps on my goosebumps on my goosebumps on my...
All right, kid. Knock it off. Just tell us what you want.
Well, I really want a new pair of sunglasses. Patrick sat on my old ones.
That's not what I meant.
Actually, it's a good thing you showed up, young sponge of goodness.
It is?
It is?
Yes. a bunch of evil robots have taken over the Mermalair security system. It's up to you to shut it down and stop them!
Well, why him? We're perfectly capable superheroes.
Because it's Thursday, and we have a whole bunch of doctor's appointments.
Ah, fish sticks. I forgot.
Go talk to the Mermalair computer in the next room. She'll tell you what to do.
I accept this awesome responsibility, Mermaid Man. You won't be disappointed. Shamed, maybe, but not disappointed.
To the doctor's office! Away!
How do I have to use in this? There it is. The invisible boat mobile.
Fortress of the wrinkly superheroes, Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy.
Squidward, am I happy to see you? And not just the kind of happy you feel in the front of your knees, but the kind of happy you feel in the back of your elbow. Oh, you'll never believe what's been happening.
Yeah, I've already been briefed by the geriatric duo. Those two old coots sent me in to get updated with the Mermalair computer. But since you're here now, I'll let you do it. It's right over there. Oh, look at this place. I mean, puttings. Would it kill them to lay down a few throw rugs? And all this wasted space? How did those two old fogies make all this?
Oh, that's easy. In episode 27, the Mermalair is invaded by the digging monsters of Bermuda, and that...
Never mind!
I'm great at throwing things.
All you have to do is pick up a throw fruit and throw it into each of those funnel machines.
Throw the throw fruit. Throw the totem.
You might want to be quick about it. I tend to explode. I mean, they tend to explode.
Woo! Up we go!
Oh, that was close.
Here, boy.
hero.
Hey, you're yellow. When did that happen?
Need a lot more power to activate the hydroacoustic Doppler modulator. You think you can handle this?
I can see Squidward's house from up here. And he's not wearing any pants. No way, he never wears pants.
Now listen up. There are 8 cylinders over there. If you throw something at the cylinders, it'll turn around to the power side. Turn all 8 cylinders around to the power side, and I'll give you a reward.
Sorry, what was that? I was watching Squidward.
Just start turning those cylinders.
That's annoying. Super not in the mood for this.
Thank you.
need all that power for?
Why, my foot bath, of course. Here, have a golden spatula.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! Pretty sparkly.
I never noticed that.
First one is here.
Press the buttons! Got it!
When you have pressed them all, you should return here to press the master shutdown button. You will be rewarded.
Return here! Got it!
Are you listening to me?
Listening! Got it!
Of the Mermalair.
Wow.
Oh, you took the elevator. Oh, how do I get to the top of this room?
Wow.
You're right. I bet those tunnels will take me up to the top. Good thinking, Gary.
under that glass? Gold, I say! My eyes are getting sweaty just looking at it. All you have to do is get into that there cup.
How do I get the ball rolling, Mr. Krabs?
You start the process by bubble bowling up this ramp to hit that button. Good luck, SpongeBob. My wallet's counting on you.
Pushing a simple button is the most satisfying. Push, 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 push.
You have got to be kidding me. Off the microphone so as not to lose my shit when doing this part, because I definitely had trouble doing this as a kid, and apparently I still have trouble doing it now. Really a little miffed. You do it, you piece of garbage. My button wasn't working for a second there. I can do this. Let's do this. It just doesn't roll far enough. Finally. Don't you fuck it. Are you serious? I'll take it. Technically, it counts, baby. Suck a dick. That counts. Wow. That was really dumb. What was the time?
Promotion?
Sure. You'll get a whole extra 10 seconds added to your break time.
Woo! 20-second break!
Do I care? No, I'm sorry, Mr. Krabs. As enticing as that sounds, I can't give this to you. I need every golden spatula I can get.
I understand, boy. I'll just dock 30 seconds from your break time instead.
Wow! That means I have a negative 20-second break. Thanks, Mr. Krabs.
That was a struggle.
I have regained control of the security system. Here is the reward I promised you. You have pressed all the security buttons. Now press the master shutdown button.
Okay, now it's boss time.
Been shut down, and we got a good checkup.
Hooray for justice in all its multi-splendor glory!
Yeah, well, Justice Boy, you also cut the power to the Mermalair's BCS. That's Villain Containment System.
Is that bad?
Does Mermaid Man smell like sour milk?
Yes! Yes, I do!
Oh, no. It looks like one of the villains is broken free.
What's that? An evil doer on the loose?
Who is it?
Man Ray? The atomic flounder? The dirty bubble?
No, worse than that. He's your arch enemy. Prawn.
Prawn!
Did someone call? Oh, I thought maybe I was looking
at you. They just made a con reference.
It's just a couple of pieces of gnarled driftwood.
Prawn! I'll never forgive you, you madman!
What did Prawn do?
The worst thing you can imagine. He put all of Mermaid Man's white clothes in the washer with a red sock.
Everything I own turned pink! Pink!
How horrible!
Personally, I thought pink made you very pretty.
Really?
Sure, pretty stupid. Yikes. What is that yellow thing? Some kind of mold?
I'm not mold, I'm a sponge. There's a cellular difference. A cellular difference!
Yeah, yeah. Thanks for the lesson, Dr. Science. See you later, Pinky.
By the seven seas, Prawn, I shall not rest until you are captured. But first, I shall have to change from my secret identity into Mermaid Man.
You don't have a secret identity, you old coot. Maybe you better take care of Prawn while I take care of this.
I shall avenge you, Mermaid Man!
Oh.
Not again! This is not fair! I got the frozen wedgie for this! Is this the end of Prawn?
Prawn is safely locked away again, thanks to you, Frankie.
My name's SpongeBob.
Here, I found this in my sock drawer, next to a bunch of pink socks. It's another golden spatula.
Thank you, Mermaid Man. I shall always live my life by your shining example. Let goodness and kindness...
Are you still here?
Okay, well, I did everything in the marble layer. Well, that about does it for today's stream, guys. I know it was pretty chill, I didn't really say a whole bunch, but, yeah, once again, there's a scheduled stream coming up in a couple days here on Friday the 12th, at around 8 p.m. Central Standard Time, weather permitting, however, because right now where I live, which is in Minnesota, I know, bad decisions, but... there's a weather storm coming, and it may not be, like, a good idea for my friends who are going to join in the several-day stream to actually come up to my place and do that, or me travel. Basically, people shouldn't be traveling by car at all. That's how bad it's supposed to be. It might not be as bad as they say. Maybe it will completely miss us. Maybe we're just screwed. Who's to say? I guess I'll find out more about that tomorrow, probably. I'll update the Facebook and Twitter pages. But you can go ahead and follow those if you want to get more updates on what's going on. That and stolen memes. I post a lot of stolen memes, more so on Facebook than I do on Twitter. If you liked what you saw today, go ahead and leave a like. Or nah. Do whatever you want. I'm not your dad. I'm not your mom. But go ahead and subscribe if you think you like what we do here. We got more things and streams. We got reviews, old Let's Plays, what have you, essentially. Podcasts as well, Flavorcasts. Go ahead and hit that bell if you want to know exactly when that stuff happens and you get notifications, because it's not enough just to subscribe anymore. You got to hit that bell. But thanks so much for watching. I'm getting out of here. Peace out, everybody.